Hey everyone, Mike Mulligan here from Blind on the Move, and in today's video, I'm going to be talking about an accessibility feature called Assistive Access that is built into iOS devices like this iPhone here, and how it can be helpful for somebody with a visual impairment. So let me show you how it works. All right, so Assistive Access is an accessibility feature that was released with iOS 17, and essentially it simplifies the iPhone screen from a complex screen like I have here with a lot of different icons and a lot going on to a very simplified screen. And it was designed primarily for people with cognitive abilities, but because of its layout and the way it's designed, I find it can be really helpful for somebody with a visual impairment or low vision, especially if they're not that tech savvy. So let me show you how to access it and how it works. So to get to the Assistive Access accessibility feature, you're going to tap on Settings. So I'm going to tap on Settings here on my phone. I'm going to scroll down until I get to Accessibility. I'm going to tap on that. And then I'm going to scroll down again. There's a lot of accessibility features built into the iPhones, which is great. I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom. And in the bottom section under General, there's Assistive Access. So I'm going to tap that. And now here, there's a lot of different options with settings that I want to talk about briefly. The top one says Start Assistive Access, so we're going to save that one. Here we have Applications. So this is where you can manage your apps. So it's very limited on what apps you put in there. So that's actually a good thing because right now for my selected apps, I have Calls, Camera, Messages, Magnifier, and Scene AI. So there's only 5 options that a person can select when in this mode instead of all the options that someone would normally have, but you can add a lot of different ones. And another thing I want to point out is some of the basic ones like music, photos, also messages, camera, and calls is optimized for Assistive Access. So I'll show you what that looks like, but some apps are designed to be used in Assistive Access, which can be really helpful. So after the items are selected, I will go back, the apps that I want to have in Assistive Access. Next option is between rows or grid mode. So it really depends on the person and what they like. I find grid to be a nice option. That's the way it'll lay out the icons, which you'll see in a minute. You can change your wallpaper, allow volume buttons, allow silent mode. So there's some customization that can be done here. Show time on lock screen, show notification badges. So depending on what you're looking for, that could be helpful to change those different settings. Siri can be turned on or off. Oh, it heard me there. So it can be a great way of providing those voice commands. So now that I've gone through kind of the basic features, I'm gonna start Assistive Access. So I'm gonna tap on the top icon and there's a password. That way if you're doing this for maybe a family member or someone who might find their way out of the app, there's a passcode so it remains in Assistive Access if that's what you're looking for. So I'm gonna type in my passcode here. And now it says entering Assistive Access. So it takes a little bit to boot up and get going. This is a little bit of an older iPhone too, so it might take a minute here. Okay, so now it has popped up. Assistive Access is open on my phone. And on the home screen now, instead of all the different icons that you would normally get, there are just 5 icons. So I have top left, there's calls, top right, there's camera, there's middle left, messages, middle right, magnifier, and then bottom left, Scene AI. So again, this is customizable depending on what the person may be using it for. And then they can get alert. I just got alert that there was a phone call. It put a little blue bell. But one nice thing about this is these icons are really large. So for somebody with a visual impairment, it can be much easier to see and can really simplify the process. So now I'll just tap on calls and show you what that's like. So when I tapped on calls, it brought me to another screen, very basic. It just says calls on the top with the phone icon, and then you can type in a phone number. So the numbers are really large. You could type in the number of who you want to call. You can call them by tapping in the numbers, right, red to backspace, back. So very simple to use. Next is, before I go to the next one, Calls is one of those optimized apps. So they made it really simple on this Assistive Access accessibility feature to use. Next is camera, so I'm gonna tap on camera. Again, this one is simplified. And right here, with the camera app, there's just one big button that says take photo. So it makes it a lot easier to locate that button to take a picture. It's very simplified. So I can take a picture, did the click, and if I had the photo app on there, you'd be able to access that photo pretty easily. And then one last thing I want to point out is some of these other apps, the Magnifier and CNA, are not optimized for this function yet, but you can still put it on here to access it the way you normally would when you're just using the phone regularly. So if I tap CNA, bringing it up.
Short text.
So for those of you who don't know CNA, it's a great app to get a lot of information, such as text and barcodes and things like that. But I'm gonna go back here. There's messages, so that's also optimized. You can access your messages, your text messages, so it's an easy way to send messages back and forth. Magnifier is another great accessibility feature. That one's not optimized. And then when somebody's done with using assistive access, either their friend or family member who's gonna help them exit out of it, or they wanna exit out themselves, you tap the side button three times. And that can bring you to exit assistive access. And there's also a settings mode. So with settings, again, you need a password, so I'm typing in my password. And there's just some basic stuff. You can put in airplane mode, different dark modes, volume, brightness, even text size can be changed, which can be really helpful, making the text within even these apps easier in assistive access. I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna exit assistive access. Again, they want a password, so I don't go out if I don't want to, and just make it a little more secure. So it says exiting assistive access. And that will bring me back to the home screen. So that is assistive access on the iPhone. It can be a really great feature, not for everybody, but for somebody who's struggling with using their iPhone due to their vision and just having a hard time learning some of the other accessibility features, this can be a great option. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope this video was helpful in learning more about this accessibility feature on the iPhone and how it can be helpful for you or somebody you know. So please, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe to my channel. And if you click that little bell icon, you'll be alerted when a new video is available. Have a wonderful day.